Wow. Hallelujah. And how are you today? In my country, it is at night. Actually, it is past PM. I'm requesting that we come online and hear what the Lord has in store for us in this season. I had set myself to finish the month of August. We had agreed with the Lord, and I couldn't speak to you in the morning, you know, as had a purpose to do so, because God is a God of seasons. I had purpose to do some things, but then I really wanted to hear what the Lord is saying concerning us, because we have come into a moment. I request that we come online and let us speak. Kedre, come online. We have sent messages even on our ministry and the church pages, on our WhatsApp, every communication platform we have sent messages that you come online so that we can hear what the Lord has in store for us. Amen. I'm not going to be long. I came here to deliver a word of God to prepare you for the season that we are about to enter into from the month of September. I just want to go direct to the Word of God. I want to begin today by reading the Word of God, and I'm going to read the Word of God from the book of Thank you, Gladys. God bless you. Share the Word of God. Invite many. Let us hear what the Lord has in store for us. Now, I'm going to read the Word of God from the book of Exodus, depending on your pronunciation, chapter 23 from verse 20. I'm going to read the Word of God, because that is exactly what we are about to witness. Jesus says, I did not come to abolish the law. I did not come to destroy, but I came to fulfill the law and the prophets. He came to fulfill the law and the prophets. And so we are admonishing the part of the church that says they only depend on the New Testament. No, the New Testament is a shadow. That Jesus is the Melchizedek of the Old Testament. So there is nothing that is to be destroyed. There is nothing that is of no importance in the Word of God. Every scripture is a breath of God. Hallelujah. Every scripture, even what we don't like reading, you know, some of those places you go through them, they seem to be very boring. The Word of God, every scripture. Now, in the olden days, we had the scroll. So the chapters were put for our understanding and to enable us, you know, to ease the studying of the Word of God. But every scripture is the breath of God, and it is fight for you and for your walk of faith. Hallelujah. So whether it is the New Testament, by the way, let me surprise you. For the few days I have walked with God, I have realized when I read the chapter of Exodus 20 and I come to read it another day when led by the Spirit of God, it will have a different meaning altogether. It will have a very different meaning altogether in the name of Jesus. So let us not keep aside the Old Testament. So let us be led by the Lord. Let us be the Lord led by the Lord. Let us know what does God want you to study. What is the Spirit of God say for you at that particular moment? And it is really going to be a blessing for you in the name of Jesus. So quickly, I want to read the Word of God, because I have written too much, and I want to deliver this Word of God, because it is the now word. It is the now word. I came to bring you the now word. Amen. Now the Bible says in the book of Exodus, chapter 23, from verse 20, behold, this is God speaking to the children of Israel, and he's telling them, I will set an angel before you to keep you in the way and to bring you into the praise which I prepared for you. Now, God is showing the children of Israel, I have begun a good of delivering you from Egypt. You have not been this way. You don't know where you are going. You know the name of where you are going, but you don't know the direction of that particular land. So God is telling the children of Israel, I have set before you my angel who is going to lead you, who is going to show you the way. The angel is going to lead you on that particular way so that you can get that praise that I prepared for you. Now, I have begun a journey with you, and there is a praise I have prepared for you. So for you to get that praise I have prepared for you, as your father, I have already set an angel to go ahead of you, to take to that place. That means if you cooperate with him, you'll get there. Because with him are my commands. With him are my instructions. With him are my do's and don'ts. With the angel that I've set before you are what I need done on this way. So you must cooperate with him. Children of Israel, you don't have an option. You must cooperate with this angel because he's calling with him. Hallelujah. The map, the direction, the do's and the don'ts. Hallelujah. He will caution you when you get to the Hittites, the Hittites, when you get to the Jebusites, when you get to the Amorites, you don't know how to deal with them. The angel that I have set before you, because I'm going to take you to those lands. I am cutting, because I know the scriptures now, I'm now cutting short the whatevers so that you can read the word of God for yourself. Now, I'll take you to those people. I'll take you to the lands of your enemies, the Hittites, the Jebusites, the Canaanites, the Perizzites, hallelujah, Jebusites, I'll take you to their lands, hallelujah, but I'm not taking you there to shame you, I'm taking you there to go and overthrow them, to go and take over, to go, you know, it is anywhere I'll take you, even if it is in the camp of your enemy, I'm not taking you there so that you can be defeated, so that you can lose it, I'm taking you there because the angel that is reading you has already gone ahead of you to make sure that every enemy ahead of you on your journey to the land that which I have already prepared for you is already a won battle. Hallelujah. So the Lord is telling the children of Israel that you don't have, when you get to those places, don't serve their gods. Hallelujah. Don't bow down to their gods. Not serve them. Don't do things according to the way they work. Hallelujah. Don't copy the ways of the heathen. My brethren, do not do business. Everybody could be compromising. Everybody could be doing this. Everybody could be speaking lies so that they can get business contracts. But where the Lord is taking us, know that you are still his children. There are do's and don'ts. There are things you cannot do in your marriage because they don't belong to your kingdom. Hallelujah. Even as we walk, oh my God, thank you, Holy Spirit. Let me just go through it the way the Spirit of God is taking it. Hallelujah. Now, God is telling the children of Israel that he's going to set their fear before their enemies. Anywhere they're supposed to pass through and there may be opposition, you know, God is saying, I will set my fear before you. Hallelujah. So my fear, oh my God, even before you appear, people will know of your God. People will have heard of your God. People will know what your God is able to do. Hallelujah. So by the time you appear there, the enemies of your walk of faith, the enemies of the kingdom we profess to belong to, the kingdom of the living God, they will already be fearing and trembling because of his presence and because of his deeds. Hallelujah. Now, the Lord is telling the children of Israel, if you serve me, hallelujah, I love verse 25. Now, you shall serve the Lord your God, and he will bless the bread. He'll bless your bread and your water, and I will take away sicknesses from your midst. None of you shall suffer miscarriage or barren in your rut. I will fulfill the numbers of your days. Now listen to this. Now, you're not alone in the world, but because I have begun a journey with you, and there is somewhere I am taking you, it is a good work I have begun in your life. So there are things I'm going to do. Even if everybody is saying there is no bread, God is saying, I will, you know, as I was reading this word, I was getting something very, very exciting. You know, even if you pass through some nations, and they are saying that, you find it is a season of dryness, it is a season of hunger. For you, if you serve me, even in those particular nations, the Lord is saying, I will bless your bread and your water. That means there will be provision. God is not blessing the bread that he has not provided for us. So I will bless your bread. I will bless your water. That means there will be provision for for you on this journey. I will deal with your enemies. I will deal with every opposition, because my angel is here to guide you in every aspect, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So there will be provision for you on the journey. There will be water for you. You never get thirst. Hallelujah. And not only that, the Lord is saying he will take away sicknesses. So whatever is affecting the people who do not know God, the people who've been, you know, if God is setting his fear ahead of us, so whatever everybody else is fearing in the world, the things people are fearing, like now whatever has been happening in the world, anybody connected to God, we cannot fear. We cannot fear these things, because what? Ahead of this, the reports of the enemy, ahead of whatever demonic spirit the devil has been throwing in the world, now the fear of God has already gone ahead of us to counterattack this one. Hallelujah. That's why for many of us who are born again and Holy Spirit filled, we never feared corona at whatever moment. Nothing about us is stopped. It's only that we were in nations and we are still citizens of some of these countries. So we had to fit into some of these rules and regulations. But let me tell you, in our spiritual being, there has never been fear. Because what? Sicknesses, my God, whatever is... God is saying, when you serve me, I will remove, I will take a sickness away from you, from your midst. Hallelujah. Our children, our fellow brothers and sisters in the Lord, in our nations and all over the world, anybody who is, because this word is going to go all over in the world, anybody who is born again. Now, whatever the devil, whatever the kingdom of darkness is inventing, any kind, because I told you from the beginning of this year, I said after this, even after this thing they brought, this evil spirit they brought another day, in the month of March, I want to let you know that they are planning another bigger evil, because whatever they intended with this evil has not manifested the way they really wanted. It has not fulfilled their agenda. And I have always said, listen to me, everybody. God will never allow anything happen unless it is in his time. Hallelujah. Unless it is in his time. So the kingdom of darkness could be laboring, and the agents of the devil, they want to take over the world. They want to control human beings. They want to bring their evil vaccines. They want to control whatever they put some, you know, in those vaccines, they want to say they are controlling sicknesses, but they want to put some dissolved things in, you know, to some technology in our bodies, so that they can now control the human race. Now listen to this. God is the owner of the universe. He's the Bible says the earth and the fullness therein belongs to him. So anything you see God allowing to happen in your life as a child of God, it is ordained of him, because God will never allow anything happen unless it is ordained of him. Now, I'm being reminded in the spirit of God, when the devil hit the life of Job, it was allowed of God. And that's why Paul is saying, God will never allow you be tempted. Behold what you cannot bear. Hallelujah. Because God is a father. Amen. So anything God will allow us to go through when we are still here on earth, before Jesus comes back for us. Now, let me surprise you. It will be allowed of God. Hallelujah. I'm about to tell you some things by the grace of God tonight. Now listen to this. So God is saying, I will remove, or I will take away sicknesses from your midst. So that means when the kingdom of darkness, the people who do not know God, they are suffering from sickness. Now this is what Jesus is saying. I did not come to abolish the law. I came to fulfill the law and the prophets. Hallelujah. So God is already speaking here, and we see on the cross Jesus is saying, it is finished. I have finished. I have dealt. And he was, and you know, he went through 39 stripes. He went through all those things. And the Bible says in the book of Isaiah 53, by his stripes, you know, our healing is already perfected. That is what he finished on the cross. It is already done. Hallelujah. So this is a promise that was there for the children of God from the book of Exodus. If you serve me, I will bless your waters. I will bless your bread. I will take away or remove sickness from your life. And the Bible is saying, now when I'm talking about sickness, I'm not talking about the physical sickness. I'm talking about emotional sickness. I'm talking, because God is an all-out God. Hallelujah. Our Father is an all-out Father. Hallelujah. If he's healing my body, he will sort out my emotions. He will sort out my desires. He will sort out everything about my life, because when he comes to deal with my life, it is an all-out dealing. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. So the Bible says, and the Bible is saying, he will remove sicknesses from us. And the Bible says, no one shall suffer miscarriage. Are you hearing me, church? Now, these are the things I've been speaking to the church from yesterday, because the Lord is saying, even if there was a miscarriage in your dream, Rikayando Robozia, Aramahando Robosaya. Thank you, Holy. The Lord, Rikayando Robozia. The Lord is saying, even if there was a miscarriage, you conceived a dream in me, and because of the issues of life, there was a miscarriage. The Lord is now speaking to us and saying, this particular time, hallelujah, there will be no miscarriage. There shall none of you shall suffer a miscarriage or be barren in your life. Hallelujah. There will be no barrenness. Hallelujah. Other people will suffer barrenness, but if they want to see people who are able to give birth, they'll be looking for the church. Hallelujah. If they want to see people who dream and their dreams come to pass, if they want to see people who dream about their children, who have visions, who get business ideas as ordained by the Lord, and they break through, they'll be looking for the church, and they'll be wondering, how are you doing it? What is happening? Because the Bible is very clear in the book of Micah chapter 4. The Bible says, in these days, I'm not talking about those days anymore. I'm saying in these days, the hill of the house of God, hallelujah, it shall be elevated above any other hill, above any other mountain, the mountain of the house of God. That means the Lord is about to pack the house, the lives of his children with so much glory. Hallelujah. Oh my God, so much glory that we shall not be hidden anymore. Hallelujah. We have spoken in tongues. They never valued that. And they were looking at us and they were seeing. Oh my God, even if she's speaking in tongues, even if she's reading the Bible throughout, nothing, I'm even better off. You know, people of the world have been bragging and have been saying, I am better off than them. I'm about to speak to you about three R's. Three R's. Hallelujah. I'm about to speak to you about three R's. Hallelujah. R. I'm about to speak to you about three R's tonight. What God has deposited in my spirit. And I know it's going to be a blessing to your life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So God is showing them, even if you pass through the land of the Jebusites and you fight barrenness there, for you, none of you will be hit with that. That there will be no spirit of impartation for you. Because as you walk along, this is my journey, this is my journey with you. I have begun it with you in my time. I have come to make everything possible for you and everything beautiful for you, my children, in the name of Jesus. Oh my God, when you pass by the Jebusites and you find that they are suffering sicknesses, you pass there and those sicknesses in their ladder will not be your portion, because I have already taken sicknesses from your lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And the Bible is saying, I will fulfill the days, I will fulfill the number of your days. That means there will be no premature death for us. My God, they may try to bewitch us. My God, they may even set their demons to kill us in accident and all those things. But let me tell you the truth, none of us is going anywhere. We shall live to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. We are not going anywhere. The giver of life is our Father, and we are about to live. Hallelujah. There will be no premature death. So for those who are fearing death, my God, for us, even when we pass through the Jebusites, the Hittites, and all those people, even if we find all of them are dying, they are being swept, you know, because of wickedness, we shall pass there and we shall live. Hallelujah. We shall enjoy the fulfillment of our days in the presence of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I love the word of God. Hallelujah. So what is the Lord saying to us at this particular moment? Let me read for you. The Rema word. I'm putting away my Bible for some moment because I want to read for you the Rema word, and I'm going to be very fast. So if you are inviting somebody, please, Modoni from Chuka, just invite somebody. Hadassah, my dear, I love you. Mama Mombi, Eva, Pastor Eva, God bless you. Let us invite people. Let us hear what the Lord has in store. You can share the video. Just share the video. Let us come online. Just don't just watch alone. Let us share the video and hear what the Lord is saying. If you can write down, I'm about to give you the Rema word from the mouth of God for this season from September. And behold, by the grace of God in the name of Jesus. So the Lord is speaking about three R's. Three R's. Mama Mumbi, you are a teacher. Three R's. Hallelujah. So I'm going to speak about three R's. So everything that God has given me, I have some notes with me. It is all hidden. It is all incorporated in those three R's. The Lord has just downloaded this word to me this evening. So I'm calling it a Rema word for this season by the grace of God. Now, yesterday but one, as I sat in my house, the Lord spoke to me and told me that we are entering into the beginning of a new season. We are entering into the beginning beginning of a new season. And now from the month of September, and behold, and behold, I don't know how long it will take. I don't know how long it will take, but we have entered into a season of the new. We have entered into a season of the new. And this season of the new, we are about to encounter strange faces, faces of PH, not FA, PH, PHA. We are about to encounter strange faces. Now, I want to surprise you today. When the children of Israel began a new journey, it was such a new journey. They had never encountered the episode of the Red Sea. They had never encountered the pillar of fire and the cloud on their way anywhere. They had never witnessed the wilderness in their lives. It was such a new thing that God began with them, and God is doing the same thing right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So God is about, I know some of you are saying, I have been doing business. You are about to encounter the new. If that is a business that is ordained for you, and if you're going to enjoy the blessing, the Lord is saying, I will bless your bread and your water. If you're going to enjoy the grace of maintenance for this hour, then God is about to hit even your own marriage with the new. Hallelujah. So I'm requesting the church, let go and let God. Let go and let God. Hallelujah. He's going to deal with any kind of enemy that has been opposing, that has been messing up, bringing a lot of noise in your own house, in your own business. There's no prophet and all those things. God is causing fear and terror for the sake of his children in the name of Jesus. The businesses of the children of God will be honored because we are in a season of three R's. I'm about to talk about the three R's tonight by the grace of God. So we are in that season. We are about to, it's about to get to midnight. So we are about to cross over to a season of the new. Now, don't depend on yesterday's grace. The yesterday's grace cannot maintain you today. Cannot maintain you today. We are about to enter, we are about to see gross darkness hit the earth. Gross darkness hit the earth. But the Bible says the light of the Lord shall shine upon the righteous. Hallelujah. So what is the Lord saying? In this, you know, in strange faces, the children of Israel, you know, they were encountering a face after the other. After the Red Sea, my God, there is a wilderness, there is a Jericho war, there is a Jordan River. There were faces every moment. There were faces. Hallelujah. And I want the church to know, in this, they are going to be strange faces. Hallelujah. And that's why the Bible says, those who endure to the end, those who endure to the end, and blessed is that servant will be found so doing. You'll be found so doing. Hallelujah. Let me read the word of God. Hallelujah. Now, this marks a totally new moment that will be characterized with the new and strange faces for all mankind. It is not only for the born again, but what is about to happen. Now, let me surprise you. What happened to the walls of Jericho? It happened. It was witnessed even by the owners of Jericho, by the residents of Jericho. So what is going to happen? Then the strange faces that are about to be encountered by the children of God, they are all going to be, you know, there will be witness by every humankind in the world in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Even those who think they are very high, they are going to witness this because it's the season of God in the name of Jesus. The Bible is, the word of God is saying tonight, now, being the season of the end times, God is expecting the church to avoid complacency. Avoid complacency. This is not time to slow down. The Lord is saying, it is not time to slow down, but a moment to do the work. It is a moment to do the work. And the Lord is saying, in my kingdom, I don't have spectators. I don't have anybody. That's why God is speaking generally to the children of Israel and telling them, if you serve me, not one, not Joshua, not Moses, not Caleb, if you serve me, if you don't work like the people, the heathen, if you don't bow to worship their gods, hallelujah, then I'm going to do one, two, three things. So the Lord is saying, it is not time to bow down to the things of this world. It is not time to give in to the intimidating voices of this world. We have always said we are here, but we are not for here. In this world, we are sojourning. We are ambassadors of Christ, hallelujah. And I have always said, an ambassador sent to a particular country, they represent their citizenship. They represent their country, that where they, you know, where they belong. Hallelujah. So somebody could be our ambassador in America from Kenya. Hallelujah. He is there. I know his name. He's from my home county. Hallelujah. But he's there representing the will. He's there representing the constitution of his country, and fighting for the sorry, fighting for the, you know, for the rights, and you know, for whatever is supposed to be, you know, to be for the good of his country. He cannot be there representing his country and then he bows to the intimidation. If that particular country says they are against his country, then he cannot team up with them because he's an ambassador. Hallelujah. Now listen to this. So the Lord is saying, it is no time to slow down. Amen. Even if you fight the word from this hour, even if you fight any opposition on your way, Church of Jesus, the Bible says, whoever will persevere, those will persevere to the end. Meaning what? We have to endure to the end. Meaning what? Anywhere you see the word endurance, my God, it's getting hot here. Now, anywhere you see endurance, there's going to be kind of an opposition. Hallelujah. So you have to endure. So we are going to do our business despite anything. We shall not bow to the intimidating voices of the kingdom of darkness. They may report whatever they want to report. They may say whatever they want to say. But the Bible says we are seated with Christ in heavenly places. So our mind, the Bible says, let our mind be like let the mind that was in Christ be in us. Hallelujah. That mind, hallelujah. Oh my God. And I request the Church of Jesus Christ, get to know your Savior. Get to know him. Know the characteristics of Jesus so that you are able to emulate him by the grace of God in the name of Jesus. So the Lord is speaking to the church. I said I'm a very first prophet. Hallelujah. So the Lord is speaking to the church and saying, learn your race with endurance. Learn your race from whichever country you are coming from. Don't panic. Rikayando Robozia. Even if they report what next month, my God, within less than 3 months, you're about to hear another new disease. Bad one than whatever is diminishing right now. You're about to hear another one. That one is going to affect the skin of people. Hallelujah. Because the devil is very mad. He has not been able to accomplish his agenda because they still want to bring forth their vaccines and the whatever demonic agenda they have. Now, listen to this. Now, even if you hear all those things, our faith will remain very intact. And I have always said to the church, we cannot pray out the signs of end times. Jesus is telling the disciples, when you see this, know that the end is near. So meaning what? You will see. Oh, hallelujah. You will see. We shall see. Hallelujah. We shall see. And when we see, we shall know the end is near. But that means, why are we going to know? Because this, whatever we shall see, will not affect that. We are not a portion of that. We are here where, so whatever this operation is being controlled, that's where our Savior is seated and he's interceding for us. So we cannot be affected by these things. Our mindset is not for here. Our mindset is where we are seated with Christ in heavenly places in the name of Jesus. So run your race with endurance, looking unto Jesus, the author. And I have always said, the people, people in my country, we have marathoners in our country. No, you don't slow down when you're almost finishing. Because if you slow down, somebody can overtake you. So keep the pace. Keep the pace. Hallelujah. Keep running. Keep the pace. Hallelujah. And learn the race with endurance, looking unto Jesus, not looking at anybody. Because right now we are in end times. If you look at somebody and they mess up, you are going to lose heart. You're going to have your heart broken. Hallelujah. So look unto Jesus. That's what Paul is saying. The author and the finisher of your faith. Because the Lord is saying, Jesus remains our role model. Hallelujah. Because he is the head of the church. Hallelujah. And I have always said, no, none of us will stand before the Lord and say, I did this because my pastor told me to do so. I did this because the word of God will judge you. Hallelujah. If it is not written in the word of God, it does not matter who says it is the way. If it is not the word of God, hallelujah, then it is not of God. And anything that is not of God from him and by him and in him, by him and for him, then it is a sin. Hallelujah. So avoid anything that can defile you in this hour. The other thing is that the Lord is saying he has brought us into that prime moment of reward. God has brought the remnants of his people into that prime moment of reward here on earth. Jesus is telling the disciples, 1 Peter is asking Jesus, what about us? We have left this and we have followed you. Jesus is telling them, here on earth, there is going to be a reward. And in heaven, there will be another reward. And then here on earth, there will be persecution. Hallelujah. That's why I'm saying you must endure. Even the reward is coming, but there's that particular portion of the scripture that we always forget. There will be persecution. Hallelujah. Now, the Lord is saying he has brought the remnants of his people to that prime moment of reward. Hallelujah. This is where everything that God has promised your life, you from the month of September, and behold, I don't know how long it will take before Jesus comes back, but we are going to begin seeing the reality of that which God promised us. We are going to begin seeing the fulfillment of the prophetic words that have been spoken to our lives. We are going to begin seeing, oh my God, the tangible manifestation of the power of our kingdom. Hallelujah. My God, without any strain, you'll be speaking to the sick and commanding them, I command you to arise, you are healed, and this healing will be perfected by the words of your mouth in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are about to see, when you lay your hands on the lame, we are about to see them walk, not by might, but by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. We are about to see the manifestation of the power of God in the world, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So the Lord is saying he has brought us into that moment of reward. Amen. Now, in this moment of reward, the Lord is requesting for those who hearken to the voice of the Lord, and those who have been following him. Hallelujah. God has brought you into a moment of reward. I know for some of us it has not been very good. It has not been a smooth sailing thing. It has not been so good. Nevertheless, hallelujah, the season of shame, Irika Yendorobozia, Arama Handorobozia, the season of shame is over. Hallelujah. The season of mockery is over. Oh my God, the season of hard labor in Egypt is over. God has seen the tears, he has heard the cry, and now he has come to reward us, and each one of us will receive a reward according to what God preordained for your life. Even before you are conceived in your mother's womb, there is that which God had preordained for your life, and that is what exactly you are about to see by the grace of God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And the Lord is saying we are going to get hold of that which he ordained for us in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Joseph, it is time for your dream to become a reality. You are about to become the second in command in a foreign country. Esther, nobody has prophesied for you or anything, but you're about to praise Vashiti. Hallelujah. My God, Mordecai, your time to remain a watchman by the gate is over. You are about to be elevated to the destiny that I ordained for you. Somebody like Mephibosheth, it does not matter what the devil tried to destroy in your life. Even if you are lame, even if you are forgotten, Erodiba, there is an inheritance. There is a promise for you. There is an inheritance for your father and for your grandfather. And even if the devil has been trying to hide you, it is now time for your reward. You must eat from the king's table all the days of your life. Hallelujah. So David, you have been hidden there taking care of your father's sheep, but God has already ordained from the beginning that you are the king who is going to replace Saul in this generation. So the Lord is saying, whatever I preordained for you, you may not know how it is going to become, but this is a time of that reward where that which God ordained for your life shall become a reality in the name of Jesus. I know somebody is saying, I even don't have the vigor, I don't have the strength to pray anymore. Hallelujah. Somebody sent me a message this yesterday night, and I really loved that. And that person was telling, Mama, you are challenging me. How could you be preaching in this kind, this particular, dark hour of the world? Hallelujah. Even when people are so stressed, they are so stressed, they are not even able to pray because of whatever is happening around in the world. And I'm like, God, this is where our grace is being perfected. Hallelujah. Our strength is being renewed every day in the name of Jesus. Because, oh my God, we are anointed. We cannot lock ourselves in like other people. We must keep on encouraging the church and building your faith and telling you all is well, because that's the reason why we are anointed. Hallelujah. Now the Lord is saying our labor in the Lord has not been in vain. Are you hearing, child of God? Your labor in the Lord, even where your family members deserted you, they could not understand you, the Lord is saying your labor in the Lord has not been in vain. Your rewarding hour is here. The Lord is saying it is a moment for the prophetic alignment. That's why I told you, take a pen and a paper. It is a moment for the alignment, for the alignment of the end time church. Hallelujah. The end time church brigadier. You know, some of these things the Spirit of God tells me I have to go to the dictionary and check the meaning. The Lord has said it is a moment for the prophetic alignment of the end times church brigadier. Hallelujah. Now, which is going to be made of the true apostles and the true prophets, hallelujah, whose heart and whole being is to align the body of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, to fit into the heartbeat of the general commandant. Ha! Hallelujah. I have to go to my dictionary and check off these things. Now, that I've just written the word of God from the Spirit of God. Now, Jesus Christ is our general commandant. So, the end time, God is aligning. In every nation, you're going to see this alignment, because it is the alignment of God. We are going to see that prophetic alignment of the end time church brigadier, hallelujah. And the Lord is saying it is going to be made up of the true apostles and the true prophets, hallelujah, who are sold out to God. They are not living for themselves. They are not after material things. They know, when I seek the kingdom of God first, all other things are going to be added unto me. They are not learning helter skelter to fit in to the status quo, where people are going to get powers from other demonic altars so that they can become influential even in the things of God. My God, this is not what I'm talking about. The people who are sold out to God, and they know God is my strength, hallelujah, these are the people God is saying, God is going to now align them so that they can now align the heart and build the church of the children of God, the entire body, to fit in to that which is a heartbeat of our general commandant, who is Jesus Christ, the head of the church. Hallelujah. Now, it is high time that all in the army get fully equipped. It is time for the church of Jesus Christ. So, to fully get equipped. That's why the Bible says, when people gathered around Jesus, he taught them the word of God. This is a foundation we have. We see Paul is able to pass, the teaching. He's able to bring up a son. He's able to mentor. He knows, I began this ministry, but I'm not the beginning and the end. I'm not everything. I need to impact to my son. So after I'm long gone, my son Timothy will take it up. My son Titus will take it up. Hallelujah. And I want to ask a question to every servant of God who is going to watch me, wherever you're going to watch me. That ministry that God, that dream that God put in your spirit for a ministry, are you everything? Are you raising sons? Are you impacting? Hallelujah. So we are in that particular moment where the church of Jesus Christ, this particular moment, there has been a lot of noise. There has been a lot of gimmicks, but people are going out to yearn. The hearts of people are going to yearn to hear the truth that is the word of God. Hallelujah. People have not been loving prayer and teaching of the word of God. Now people are going to flock. Even the heathen, the Nicodemus, will be looking for Jesus tonight. They really want to know the truth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. With their robes and everything, they'll be looking for the truth. So because Jesus is preparing, they're preparing the church, everybody. I say there is no spectator. So we are all going to be equipped and be fully equipped and prepared for the end time assignment. I said each one of us is supposed to be serving God in our own capacity. So we are all going to be equipped. And the Lord is talking about to be fully equipped for this end time assignment in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Where the body of Jesus Christ will walk together and work together as a unit. Hallelujah. Somebody will not be saying this here and another one will be saying something else in another country. The body of Jesus Christ, that the little one will be speaking one language. If I speak this in Kenya, another one in Asia is saying the same things. Because what? It will be one unit. The body of Jesus Christ is one unit. Hallelujah. And that's why I'm saying there's going to be a clear demarcation. It is going to be very clear. Those who are in the kingdom of God, serving God in truth and in spirit, and those who are camouflaging. It is going to be so clear. God is here to make it very clear for the glory of the name of the Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We shall witness much returning back or restoration of our fallen soldiers. There is going to be such a quickening in the spirit. That's what Jesus is telling. He's saying, Father, those who you gave to me, none of them, I have not lost any. Hallelujah. None of them will get lost. Now listen to this. There is going, from this month of September, we are going to see the people who backslid. You may not even reach to them. Maybe some of them look messed up. Hallelujah. We are going to see such a restoration, such a returning back of the fallen soldiers in the kingdom of God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Some of them will come with 5 children. Nevertheless, they belong to eternity. Hallelujah. Some of them will come. Hallelujah. Some of them will come. Oh my God, even with the sicknesses and ailment, HIV, but nevertheless they belong, and when they return, God is going to heal them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Some of them will come when their businesses are all gone because they interacted with corruption and all those evil things, with lies and everything, bribery. But God is returning. And the Lord told me, this one will be nobody's operation. The Spirit of God is already quickening our fallen soldiers to be restored back, our prodigal sons to be restored back to where they belong. The Spirit of God is doing an operation. I want to surprise you today that nobody ministered to the prodigal son. He came back to his senses and he realized, I need to go back to the presence of my Father. Hallelujah. So the Spirit of God, we are in the season of the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God is already doing that operation of restoring those who belong to heaven where they belong in the name of Jesus. Now I want to surprise you by the grace of God. Now listen to this. Because of what the Lord is doing, there's going to be too much purging. Purging is removing. The Lord is saying he's going to remove and to get rid of those who have secretly with a lot of hypocrisy, secretly and with a lot of hypocrisy, been operating illegally in the body of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. More so those who have manipulated the children of God and held them captive in their own kingdoms, because it is not the kingdom of God. They are using manipulating spirits from the kingdom of hell, marine spirits, and the demonic covenant they have gotten from demonic altars. The Lord is saying there's going to be much purging. They are going to be removed. God is going to get rid of them. Hallelujah. And some of these places, even with the mass following, they are going to become Ichabod. The glory of God will be departed, as God is going to deliver his people from such kind of places in the name of Jesus. And I want to let you know, you are about to see massive exodus, as the Spirit of God is quickening so many who are bound in some of these places. Hallelujah. Where they have been buying stuff, it has been sowing seeds and all manner of nonsense. God is delivering his people. Hallelujah. And I'm telling you, God is going to open the eyes of many, like Jesus did to those two disciples when they were going to Emmaus. He broke the bread and he opened their eyes, and they were able to understand, to come to the understanding that we are dealing with the Messiah. It is him we are talking about, and it is him. Hallelujah. So this is the operation of the Holy Spirit of God all over. I'm telling you the truth, prepare men and women of God. There are some people who have been trying even to try to reconcile back to the Lord, and you know they are meant for eternity. Without your struggle, without nothing, the operation of the Holy Spirit is already here with us. You are prepared the space. I hear the Spirit of God say, I tell the servants of God, prepare the space. Hallelujah. Buy more seats. Hallelujah. Prepare, extend the sanctuary. Hallelujah. Extend the space. Hallelujah. Because you are about to receive the souls of men as the sons of God return back home, as the Lord is preparing the church for eternity in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So where the children of God have been hijacked by the wolves in sheep clothing, the Lord is saying, I'm going to rescue them. I'm going to rescue them, and I'm going to reinstate them where they belong in the name of Jesus. You know, read the word of God, church. I don't have time because I need to release the word of God. Read the word of God in the Bible, in the book of Jeremiah 23. God has already prepared shepherds. God has already prepared pastors, men and women of God of character, people after the heart of God. Now God is about to connect these people who are getting restored back to the right ministers, to the right shepherd. Hallelujah. Men and women of God who are not living for things, but they are living for Jesus, because they know when they do it the right way, things will follow. Hallelujah. Oh my God of all glory. Hallelujah. Oh Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now listen, thank you, Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is telling me to tell the servants of God, it is not about a lot of education. All those things are good. We have all gone through those things. Hallelujah. But listen to this. Do not feel intimidated because you don't have a theology master's and whatever those things. Those things are all good. Hallelujah. We have been there and we have been there. But the Lord is saying, do not despise yourself. The Lord is about to impact his Holy Spirit and to impact knowledge and revelation, the spirit of understanding, the spirit of might, the spirit of counsel to the lives and the spirit of you know, the spirit of God is about to do all that for the sake of the understanding and the revelation of the word to the servants of God who are going to be used by God in these end times. Hallelujah. Now there'll be like the Peter, you know, there's a time Peter, they went ministering in the book of Acts chapter 3, and you know, when those people were talking, you know, the authorities of their time, they looked at those people and they were like, oh my God, these people are not even schooled, they are not even learned. Hallelujah. My God, we have come into a moment where God wants you to minister to a certain people. He will give you their language. Hallelujah. Oh my God, you'll be able to minister. Hallelujah. Where God sends you, just pack your bags and go. As now the Spirit of God will do the other operation, because the Lord is saying, my angel will go ahead of you. Hallelujah. So whatever is supposed, any help you need along the way, it is there. Any counsel you need, it's already at your disposal. Any help you need, it's there. Any connection you need, it's already there. Arise and go. Hallelujah. The direction, because I have prepared a place for you. That's what we read in Exodus chapter 3. Hallelujah. Now, it is time for that demarcation. Hallelujah. And it is going to be very, it is going to be witnessed by everybody. Hallelujah. We are just entered into a moment. Hallelujah. Where the first will be last. The first will be last. My God, we are about to see the gospel musicians, people who have really compromised, they have lowered their standards, and they are doing a lot of evil and immorality. Men and women of God, I'm not talking about all of us. My God, they are still remnants, but we are seeing a lot of immorality. We are seeing a lot of demonic covenants. My God, people, because of riches and whatever, they can even kill and do all those manner of nice, like the people of the world. Now listen to this. The first will be last. We are about to see robbers turn to Christ and hold Bibles and minister, but like what happened to Saul, it is about to happen right now. We are about to see prostitutes like Rahab, like the woman, the Samaritan woman in John chapter 4. We are about to see conversion of the people who do not look like. Hallelujah. So prepare yourself. The people who don't want to serve God, prepare yourself. Hallelujah. This is what the Bible says, the stones will do it. Now we are about to see that the heart of people who have been hardened melted, those stones melted, and they are going to serve God with vigor in the name of Jesus. First will be last. Please, my brother, my sister, make sure you're not going to be replaced. From the month of September, we are about to see that in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the Lord is saying, some of these people, they may not be qualified in the eyes of men. They may not look like Moses. Moses is a stammerer. Hallelujah. Gideon is even coming from the least family. Somebody like Jabez, you know. Oh no, somebody who was born in pain. Somebody like Jephthah, a prostitute boy. Hallelujah. My God, we are about to see such kind of things. Hallelujah. How can a barren Hannah become a mother? Oh my God, even of a prophet. How? Hallelujah. People who do, how can a virgin Mary? Nathaniel, a whole prophet, is asking, can anything good come from Nazareth? Hallelujah. Even the prophet worded, hallelujah. Can a shepherd David, oh my God, even the brothers are despising him. Hallelujah. Can this David be anointed? Even the father had forgotten about David. And someone is saying, I will not sit until he comes. My God, this is what is about to do. This is what is about to happen. Hallelujah. They may have forgotten you, but God is had rikayandolobozia. We have entered into a moment where many may have forgotten you. Hallelujah. But the Lord is not here to hadipika that which he wants to do with you, and he's going to place you where he needs it done. God is about to hadipik you, my God, my Jehovah. It is by the God's own designer that David went to see his brothers. Hallelujah. Just on time. That whole episode was orchestrated by God, my God of all glory. It was orchestrated by God for the donkeys of Kish, Saul's father, to get through just on time when someone was in the vicinity where Saul went to look for the donkeys. And it was orchestrated by God for Vashti to misbehave so that, oh my God, Esther, my God, virgins could be looked for so that Esther could become, oh my God, Mrs. King. Hallelujah. She had never dreamt about it. Nobody had even prophesied to her, but it was orchestrated by God. Now, we are about to see, Hallelujah. Even where you think, men of God, Pastor Samuel, hallelujah, where you think you are not qualified. That's what I'm hearing, man of God, Pastor Samuel Gojiri. The Lord is about to elevate you to a level where no man would have elevated you. God is about to do something, hallelujah, that is going to take you to the levels that you ordained for your life. Oh my God, I hear the Spirit of God say, the doors men refuse to open for you, and they are ordained by God, the Lord, by His own design. He's about to orchestrate episode so that you may go through those doors, and the people who refuse to open the doors for you, they are going to look and wonder, how did he make it this way? How did she go this way? It is not about us right now. It's about the operation of the Holy Spirit in the atmosphere, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh my God. So God is saying, I have already prepared those places. I've already prepared those things. Anywhere you're supposed to go. That's why he's telling the children of Israel, oh my God, the angel is ahead. He's going to go ahead of you, dealing with the enemies, dealing with your everything, dealing with everything, every opposition. He has my do's and my don'ts. What you need to do is just obey. Be very alert to obey him, because he's calling my counsel. Hallelujah. So God has already gone ahead of us. And let me surprise you. The Lord has been speaking to me, and I have written this word here, that God has already handed over the mantles. God has already handed over the end time mantles to the people who he wants to walk with and work with in this hour. My God, this one, my God, I hear the Lord say, we are going to be such a fire that even demons cannot quench. We are about to become, my God, such a fire that even the agents of the devil, whatever the devil worshippers, my God, they'll not be able to withstand this, because this one is not about us. It is about the fire of the Holy Spirit that is already burning in our spirit by the grace of God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I'm requesting the church, the older brother syndrome, the people who want to criticize and to remind them, our brothers and sisters, when they are restored back, you want to remind them where they are coming from. You want even to fast and pray so that you may discern and blah blah. Now do not waste time. These people have come back to their senses, and they are coming back where they belong, and there is nothing you can do about it, because this one is ordained by the Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now mantles have already been released. Now the Lord is saying, the mantles that were released to some people, and they mishandled them, they have already compromised. Hallelujah. The Lord is saying, those mantles will not get lost. Those mantles will be transferred. You are about to see, if you have compromised in your walk of faith and you have refused to sing anymore, you have refused to sweep the house of God anymore, you're about to see that grace, even in a Sunday school child. You're about to see, my God, you're about to see, my God, even a drunkard coming to clean the house of God very early in the morning, and then he goes away until God has finished with him. Hallelujah. The Lord is saying, those mantles where people misused and mishandled them, hallelujah, I'm already handing them over, hallelujah, to the people I'm going to entrust with my end time operation in this hour, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, mantles are already transferred, whether you like it or not. You're about to see somebody ministering the way you had dreamt. You're about to see somebody operate even in a business the way you had dreamt, and God will make sure you pass there. Hallelujah. God made sure Penina is alive to witness. Oh my God, hallelujah. God made sure Saul was still alive. He operated as a king irrigare for some years. Even after long ago, Samuel had anointed and consecrated David to replace Saul. Hallelujah. Now listen, God will always make sure. That's why I always say, do not pray for your enemies to die. Let them live. Why will God prepare a table for you? Let them live. Do not kill them by thunder, by fire. Some of these things are coming from hell. Jesus is saying, you pray for those who persecute you. Do not pray for them to die. Don't kill them. Hallelujah. Let them live. Penina must witness when you become pregnant for her to testify. Hallelujah. Now, it is an hour where all about us and for us must be led by the Lord. It is about time that everything about us, this is what is going to bring a distinction. Where the presence of God is telling Moses, Exodus chapter 33, my presence will go with you. This is what will bring a distinction when your presence goes with us. So anything now God wants you to endeavor into, anything God wants you to venture into, it must be born of him, by him, and in him. Are you hearing me, church? It must be born of him, in him, and by him. This is what God will maintain. Hallelujah. Anything else you do again is the will of God right now, it'll be a warfare for you. It'll be a warfare for you. But the angel, the operation of God has already gone ahead of us. If he has given you a business idea, even if the kingdom of darkness tries to fight against it, the angel, every operation that is carrying your victory in that business is already released. Hallelujah. So as you go on doing the business, victory will be assured. Hallelujah. If God wants you to get married and this is the right moment and you know this is the right person, there'll be no issues. By the way, we have come into a moment where the children of God, like what happened to Isaac, hallelujah, and Rebecca, there'll be no traditions. Hallelujah. My God of all, a servant getting a bride for Abraham's son, not even the parents going for the bride. Hallelujah. We shall enjoy out of traditions. We shall not be bound by traditions. Hallelujah. We shall enjoy favor. Hallelujah. And it was illegal. That's why Mordecai is telling Esther, don't tell them your originality. Don't open up. Hallelujah. God is about to conceal us where we are supposed to be enjoying favor. And oh my God, God is a miracle working God. Hallelujah. So the Lord is saying, you must go with me now because I want to make it a smooth sailing. I want to make the sail smooth for you. I want to make the sail smooth for you. Now, we remember the story of the disciples. Jesus is telling them, leave me here, dispersing the multitude. And the Bible says, he told them, let us cross over. Let us go the other side. And the Bible shows that the storms and the waves came. But listen to this. The presence of Jesus, Jesus is not even, did not even pray and command and blah, blah. He entered that ship, and the Bible says the waves and the storm ceased. Hallelujah. And the disciples were so astonished. They were like, and who is this? Hallelujah. That even, oh my God, his presence alone is coming down the waves and the storms. Hallelujah. Now, what for you to enjoy the smooth sail in these early times, you must make sure anything you venture into, I want to repeat there, even if it is a marriage, even if it is a business contract, don't just go because a door is open. I hear the Spirit of God say, be very careful about every open door in your life, because not every open door, my God, even if you have been praying and fasting for it, not every open door, even if it looks like that one, please test. The Bible says test every spirit, because even as we do all these things, the devil is going to prepare so many traps for the children of God, and he's going to dig so many pits for the children of God. But listen to this, when you allow the Spirit of God to lead you, none of these pits, my God, you are not going to fall in any one of them. You are not going to enter into any of his traps. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We shall do it the Joseph way. My God, God will always help us to escape where we are supposed to learn, or we shall learn away. Hallelujah. And God will always vindicate our lives by his grace in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now we are about to witness. Hallelujah. Oh my God. Now the Lord is saying, the way we are about to head to, some of the things, that's why I'm talking about the season of the new. Hallelujah. God knew the children of Israel, they had not gone that way. So he prepared a means for them, means of counsel, means of direction, means of protection. Hallelujah. Ministry of protection was there. Ministry of defense was there. My God, ministry of everything that they needed, oh my God, was there. Hallelujah. So in this way, some of the things, some of the dreams you're about to get from the Lord, you don't even know how, you don't even have the formula, you don't even have the know-how, you don't know how. But the Lord is saying, I know you are not familiar, because let me tell you the truth, when something is new, you are not familiar with it. Hallelujah. But God knows how. If you cooperate with him, he will give you the right connection. On the way, the Lord is speaking to my spirit right now, that even as you go in this unfamiliar process, as long as they are ordained of you, as long as I'm the one who leading you in that direction, I'm going to get you destiny helpers. I'm going to give you destiny connectors. Oh my God, you are going to get Elizabeth. People who are not going to be jealous of you. They will know who you are. They will discern who you are. and they're not going to get familiar with you. They are going to push you to the destiny I ordained for you with their resources, with their everything. They are going to, oh my God, hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. Oh my God. Rika yandolo. I hear the Lord say, do not, oh my God, thank you, Holy Spirit. I hear the Lord say, do not fear to venture into the unfamiliar places and unfamiliar things, unfamiliar routes that you have not been before. Because this time it's not about the familiarity, it's not about the usual and the ordinary. It's about the new season that is going to get you to the destiny I ordained for your life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now listen, now Satan will always, and we are about to get there, and you are about to see this church. Satan, as God is taking us, because his grace, you know what the Bible is saying in the book of Revelation, hallelujah. You know, the dark world will keep on inventing the things of darkness. Actually, we are going to see them breaking forth, one after the other, But the Lord is saying, my grace will abide in you, and my light will shine upon your life. Hallelujah. So do not be shaken by whatever the devil is inventing. You don't belong to his kingdom, you belong to my kingdom. So I know how I'm going to get you out of this. I know how I'm going to maintain you, even if it is here. I know how I'm going to maintain you. God knew how he was going to maintain the children of Israel in the wilderness. He knew when they got to the wilderness, they saw there's no water, there's nothing. But God knew. He knew his God, his Father. He knew how he was going to give them water. Hallelujah. When there was no food, he knew manna came. He knew his God. He's not another of confusion, my brethren. If God is calling you to do business in Nairobi town, don't tell me Asians are occupying the place. Please, my brother, my sister, go to Nairobi town. Get there and possess a building. The provision will come. We are reading that from the word of God. Exodus chapter 23. Hallelujah. God will do it for you. God will do it for you. Do not fear. Do not fear. If God has sent you to Zambia, go. Get a passport. Wait for the borders to be opened. Go. Hallelujah. My God, we have gone to nations where nobody invited us when God sent us. We just appeared. My God, there's not once, not twice. My God, I know some people are about to witness this. I know my daughter Elizabeth, you can confirm this. I have boarded flights and God sent me to nations where I knew nobody, where nobody invited me. I left my people. I boarded a flight. My God of all glory. I go to the airport on the other side and those people clearing me at the airport, they're asking me, who has invited you? Where are you going? I say, I am a woman of God. I am a prophet of God. And God has sent me to your country. And I asked somebody clearly for me, not once, not twice, and I never fear to be deported. And I asked that person, can you connect me to a true servant of God in your country? I remember, my God, one of the country, I was picked by a man of God and his wife and their two sons from the airport. Strangers, and today we are friends, and I'm able to do ministry in that country. So if God is sending you to a particular place, do not fear, because if it is of God, the Bible says, what is born of God overcomes the world. Hallelujah. So we are in that particular moment. Boldness. Hallelujah. The Bible says, a righteous man is as bold as a lion. Hallelujah. Oh my God. We have nothing to fear, because in us we don't have the spirit of fear. We have the spirit of love, the spirit of sound mind. Hallelujah. And the spirit of courage, the spirit of boldness, the spirit of power. That is our kingdom for you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And we are people of faith. The Bible says, the just shall live by faith. The Bible says, without faith it is not possible to please God. So that is where we are. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now God is saying, I have prepared for your help. I have prepared for your guide. I have prepared every path that is ordained for you. Everything that you need this hour. The Lord is saying, it is your season for reward. So I've prepared you for your help along the way. I've prepared for your guide along the way. Hallelujah. Your protection is there. Anything, any help you need. And I'm talking about a God who is an all-out Father. So it is already prepared in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So the Lord is saying, ours is to obey. Ours is to obey the rules and the regulations of our kingdom. Ours is to obey. And we are going to enjoy the faithfulness of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now the Lord is saying he's not going to create a new hallelujah. The new the Lord is creating is not what we are used to. Hallelujah. Children of Israel were used to Egypt every morning, hard labor every morning. So when the new came, hallelujah, they had to adjust and fit in. And we know what happened. The people who murmured, they died. Many of them died in the wilderness. The people who opposed, they could not obey the precepts of God. We see Actually, many people who left Egypt, they never made it to Canaan. Only Joshua and Caleb. Hallelujah. Only Joshua and Caleb made it to Canaan. Hallelujah. Even Aaron, a priest, did not make it to Canaan. Hallelujah. Because of what? Because if you don't, sorry. Now, if you don't obey, hallelujah, if you don't obey the things of God, if God gives you a business, then you bow down and do it like the people of the world, then you miss his protection, you miss his cover, you miss his cover. And this time, oh my God, thank you, Holy Spirit, thank you, Spirit of God, my hoop, thank you, Holy Spirit. Now, I hear the Lord say, just like the way a chick cushions, you know, the chicks, even if they are 50, a chick, my God, you know that for the people who have ever seen this, a chick is able to cushion all those chicks. Hallelujah. You know, a chicken is able to cushion all those chicks inside. Hallelujah. And you know, she's able to do her feathers like this, and she's able to cushion them and to make sure all of them are inside. Hallelujah. That is, oh my, thank you, Holy Spirit. Now, the Lord is telling me that is the way I have done it for my children in this hour, from the season of September. And behold, because of what is about to happen in the world, the gross darkness that is about to hit the earth, I'm going to cushion the marriages of my children. I'm going to cushion the businesses of my children. Hallelujah. They are going to enjoy my help. They are going to enjoy my protection. Hallelujah. They are going to enjoy in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So we shall not do things according to the way we think, but we shall totally depend on him, and we shall do according to his will. The will of God is his word. Hallelujah. Now listen to this. We are about to overthrow many things. We are about to the Bible says the wicked have been piling their wealth for us. So we are about to take over some of these businesses. Hallelujah. And we shall do it with wisdom like Daniel's of this time. Hallelujah. We are like Joseph's with excellence. We are going to do these things. Actually, when they look, they'll be like, oh my God, we wouldn't have done it this way. Hallelujah. We are I've been telling people, this disorganization that is here in the world, and many people are losing businesses and losing jobs, it's because God is about now. My God, the economy has changed hands. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The Lord is saying the economy in the world has changed hands. It has been shifted from the hands of the wicked. Some of these places of influence, some of these companies, they have locked down, so that those who dreamt about such kind of things as the children of God, they take it up, and God is about to provide for you, and you're going to do it the right way, and the name of the Lord is going to be glorified in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, we are about to dedicate some of these areas that were demonic shrines and demonic areas. We are about to dedicate them. We are about to get lands and houses in some of these places, and we are about to dedicate them to the worship of our God in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, there is a call to continue serving the Lord. There is a call to continue serving the Lord. We serve God not because of what he is giving us or what we want him to give us, but because he is God. So whatever God has called you to do, and whatever you are going to feel impressed in your spirit, please do it. And the Bible says, either in deeds or in words, you do it unto him in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, blessed is the servant who be found so doing. Not what you did, but what you be found doing when Jesus comes back. Because Jesus is coming back. Hallelujah. So, take charge. The Lord is saying, take charge of your position. Take charge of your position and continue. Take charge of your position of service. Continue serving. Take charge. If you are called to pray, pray. If you are called to prophesy, Regina and the less, let us demolish the house, the body of Jesus Christ with the grace that the Lord has given unto us in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, the Lord is saying that our provision is taken care of. Hallelujah. Despite where we shall pass, anywhere you pass, anywhere, even if there will be another season of dryness, like what God spoke to me this year about my country, Kenya, that we spare food and we gather food, you know, the cereals and all of you, because we shall experience a season of dryness. These things are there written in the word of God, so it is not something strange. Hallelujah. But God will make sure that his people are fed. God is able to feed you despite the season of dryness in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, be well positioned. the safety right now. We have been hearing that slogan, stay safe, be safe. Now, your safety as a child of God right now is remaining in your position. Remain in your position. Remain in your position. Hallelujah. Remain in your position. Now, this is all that Jesus finished on the cross, and he said, he even mentioned it, and he said, I have finished. Now, we are about to see tangible. We are about to enjoy the fruit of that finished work. Hallelujah. Fully. This is the time you are about to enjoy that full finished work on the cross. Hallelujah. There will be such a transfer of wealth from the wicked to the righteous. Wait a minute. That is where we are right now. Hallelujah. So prepare yourself. Prepare yourself. Hallelujah. Now, when we get to this level, it's because God is preparing a ground for us to win souls. Propagate the gospel. Please preach the word of God. Don't just keep the world in your accounts and hide in your houses. Please let us reach out to the souls of men. Hallelujah. Send somebody to Moyare. Pay somebody's flight. Those who, the evangelists. Hallelujah. The missionaries. Send out. Be a partaker of our ministering. Hallelujah. Let the word of God reach out to every soul in the world through your giving also in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, after this, our God will be honored and he is going to be revered. Hallelujah. After he began by saying he has prepared a place for us. That is, he told the children of Israel, why I have given you guide is because I have, this guide is going to take you to that place I have prepared for you. Now, as you walk with God as an individual, as you walk with God as a body, the corporate body, there is a place that God has prepared for us. And we know at the end of the day, there is eternity. Now, listen to this. Now, because of what God is about to do with you in your family setup, to do with you and in you, hallelujah. You know, I know you have prayed, you have fasted, and many of them would be wondering, where is your God? Now, your God is about to be honored and revered. Hallelujah. The fear and the reverence of the God of Israel was even known by a prostitute called Rahab. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. She said, we have heard about your God. So it is going to be the same thing right now in the remnant, to the remnants and for the remnants of God's people in the world in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, God knows all about the way where he's taking you, and he has already planned ahead of you. Hallelujah. He knows your needs and he knows your wants, and he's saying right now he's going to do all and to fix all for the sake of his name. Hallelujah. The path he's going to lead you, hallelujah, each one of us, it's already a finished deal. It's already a finished deal. It's not, to him it's not something new. To you it's going to be something new. The wilderness was new. Jericho wall was new. Jordan River was new. And I want to surprise you, the way they crossed over Red Sea, it's not the way they crossed over Jordan. Hallelujah. God is a God of style. Hallelujah. In his seasons, he can use any style. Hallelujah. So don't depend on your own understanding. Don't lean on your own understanding. Don't